This is Queen the Greatest, and we are remembering when Queen rocked London's West End with the launch of We Will Rock You. In May 2002, the Dominion Theatre in London opened its doors for the first time on a brand new rock theatrical experience set entirely to the music of Queen. We Will Rock You had been lovingly brought to life under the watchful eyes of Brian May and Roger Taylor, but was made possible by the unlikely pairing of Queen with a Hollywood legend.
And we had a series of scripts given to us, and Robert De Niro strangely took an interest, which was came completely from left field, and said he was starting a theatrical arm of Tribeca, his film company, and he'd like us, our musical, to be his first thing, so we ended up co-producing it.
Another key partnership was involving esteemed comedy writer Ben Elton to create the story that the hit songs would be woven into.
And it's ended up being hugely funny, as well as, you know, making some points which Ben normally manages to weave into anything he does. And so I think it's a very good mixture of having something to say, having a sort of slightly silly story, but very funny and hopefully uplifting with tons and tons of hits.
It is funny, and it's also, it has a kind of serious side. It has it has something to say, and I think you'd better bring your handkerchief as well. I think there's some moments where you'll feel something rather sad and feel something rather personal. Very often we've made very small changes to the lyrics, and sometimes none at all, and somehow they just seem to fit the story incredibly well. Now, this isn't an accident, you know, we've moulded the story around the songs, we've moulded the songs around the story. It's not just like, let's sling some songs into a story at all. It's very much, I guess we always took our work pretty seriously. So this is a genuine attempt, if you like, to make something which will stand for the rest of time as a musical, and perhaps some people in the future will forget that these songs ever had a life elsewhere, I don't know.
Predictably, some of the press reaction at the beginning was unduly harsh, but that proved irrelevant as the theatre-going public flooded in, giving the show nightly standing ovations and eventually making it the longest-running show ever to play at the Dominion Theatre. An extraordinary achievement that was marked in 2012 when the stars turned out for a gala performance to celebrate the show's 10th anniversary.
Oh, it's amazing it's been going 10 years. It just shows how popular still rock and roll is.
I was here at the first night, I absolutely love it.
I've seen it about 17 times.
Bring on another 10 years.
I think it's going to go forever. 10 years is nothing.
It's Queen songs, it'll go forever, won't it?
We've had a laugh for 10 years and so have the audience, so yeah, we're thrilled, absolutely thrilled.
Six million people have been to this building to see the show over the last 10 years. We've always been doing new stuff for the show, just keeping it alive and moving, evolving.
Internationally, the show became a global phenomenon, playing in more than 20 countries and entertaining well over 15 million people. And today, 20 years after that opening night, We Will Rock You is still going strong around the world. And with a new tour about to start in the UK, clearly Queen will be rocking the theatrical world for many more nights to come.
You big disgrace, kicking your can all over the place, singing, "We